According to Dalton's theory, the group of combination of atoms are known as elements. So elements are having specific properties like mass. Okay, the next one is the combination of elements to form compounds. So therefore, Dalton's theory clearly explains law of chemical combination, then law of conservation of mass. Means what amount of mass is consumed in a particular reaction, the same amount of mass is formed. Means energy neither created nor destroyed. According to which one? Law of conservation of mass or energy. This is one of the postulate of which one? Dalton's. So after Dalton's concept, atom was discovered. So therefore, to discuss about atomic mass is an important criteria. Now, first one is atomic mass means, to determine the atomic mass of a particular element, a reference element is required. Here, to discover or to determine the atomic mass of a particular element, hydrogen is taken as a standard element, or a lightest element is taken as a standard reference to determine the atomic mass of an element. So that particular scale is known as what? Hydrogen scale. Which scale? Hydrogen scale. Initially, by using hydrogen scale, the atomic mass of an element is determined. The atomic mass of an element is determined. So therefore, the first scale is which one? Hydrogen scale. Hydrogen scale. According to this particular scale, atomic mass of an element equals to mass of an atom in a element, mass of an atom in a element by mass of one atom. This is very, very important. Mass of one atom of hydrogen. Mass of one atom of which one? Hydrogen. So this particular scale is known as what? Hydrogen scale. So by using hydrogen scale, the mass of oxygen is calculated as 15.89. The mass of oxygen is calculated as 15.89. So by using this scale, hydrogen scale. So from this scale, the mass of, or the atomic mass of, the atomic mass of, the atomic mass of oxygen atom is 15.89. So by using this particular scale, some elements atomic masses are determined. Later, when we know the mass of oxygen, then this oxygen is taken as a standard element to calculate the another atomic masses. So that particular scale is known as oxygen scale. The second scale is, after they discover the discovery of the mass of oxygen atom, by using this particular atom, the mass of another unknown atom of an element is discovered. So therefore, the second scale is which one? Oxygen scale. oxygen scale, just according to this particular scale, the ratio of, it is which one, a ratio, mass here, here is also mass, so that is the reason why it is a relative ratio, or simply we say that which one, relative mass. So that is the reason why there is no units, it is a mass ratio, therefore it is no units. So oxygen scale, so atomic mass or relative atomic mass equals to mass of an atom by 1 by 16 approximately, which one, the atomic mass of oxygen is approximately how much, 16 only, so therefore 1 by 16 mass of one atom of oxygen. So by using this particular scale, the mass of carbon is calculated. So based on this particular scale, the mass of carbon or the atomic mass of carbon is 12.01. So after discover the atomic mass of carbon, so it is taken as a, carbon is taken as a standard scale. To determine the atomic mass. So therefore, the third scale is carbon scale. Now, among these two scales, the standard scale is which one? Carbon scale, to determine the atomic masses of elements. Okay, so these two are first discovered, later, if you know the atomic mass of carbon, so this scale was introduced by scientist, so therefore carbon scale. Now it is a standard scale. It is which one? It is a standard scale. Okay, to determine the atomic masses of elements. Now according to this particular scale, okay, relative atomic mass equals to mass of an element by 1 by 12th part. Which part? 1 by 12th mass of one atom of C12 isotope. Which isotope? C12 isotope. So this is very, very important. So nowadays, by using this particular standard scale to determine the atomic masses. So that is the reason why this is which scale? A standard scale among hydrogen scale and which scale? Oxygen scale. Now, by using this particular scale, the atomic mass of hydrogen is calculated accurately, that is 1.008. So therefore, from this particular scale, mass of hydrogen atom is, that is 1.008. Then one more element, atomic mass is also calculated accurately, that is mass of oxygen. Mass of oxygen equals to 15.92. Earlier is what? 15.89 by using which scale? H scale. So by using a standard scale, the mass of oxygen is what? 15.9. So that is the reason why this is one of the standard scale. So in nowadays, if any element is discovered, if any element is discovered, its atomic mass is calculated accurately, an instrument known as mass spectroscopy. So by using mass spectroscopy, we can calculate atomic mass of an element accurately, or new discovered element's atomic weight is calculated. So therefore, which one is the standard here? Mass spectroscopy. Mass spectroscopy. Mass spectroscopy is a standard instrument to determine the atomic masses. So therefore, atomic mass may be defined as, atomic mass may be defined as the ratio of mass of an atom is equals to 1 by 12th part of mass of one atom of carbon C12 or C12 isotope. So this is known as what? Atomic mass.